Hello my dear students, in this video I'll be discussing some questions from exercise 5.1. So here I have taken the second question, and here we need to make a frequency distribution table using telemarks, and we have to draw a bar graph also to illustrate this. Now how to prepare a frequency distribution table? See here, they have given the question like this. The shoppers who come to a departmental store are marked as man, women, boy or girl. The following list gives the shoppers who came during the first hour in the morning. So this is WW means woman, women, women, then girl, boy, woman, man, like this. Okay. So these are the total number of shoppers who came to the that particular departmental store during the first hour. Now for this particular distribution, we have to make a frequency distribution. Okay. See here, this is a data which is unorganized, and if we go on counting, see women first here came 3, then here again women are there. So if we go on counting like this, it will take a lot of time, and that's why this type of data, this is a raw data, isn't it? So when we need to organize the data, then we make frequency distribution table. Here the raw data is being organized. Okay, so that one is frequency distribution table. Here what we do is we count the frequency of particular observation by using telemarks. Now what do we mean by telemarks? Okay, we will come to that one. So when I am going to make a frequency distribution table, okay, I am making it here. Okay, so while making frequency distribution table, what are the different things that we need to do? See, first, what are these? Women, men, what are these? These are the category of shoppers. So we can make the first column like this. Let us make this one as category of shoppers. Okay. What are the different categories? There are women, there are men, there are girls, there are boys. Four categories. Here we will write telemarks. And here the last table is called, this is what is called frequency. This is frequency. Okay. Now, if we go on counting like this, that how many women are there, you may get confused. So the easiest way is go on counting from the first one. First one is women. Okay. So we will be giving here for one, we will mark one. Again, women, gone. Women, gone. So this three, gone. The fourth one is girl. So here for one girl, we will be writing telemarks will be given like this. Okay. So for one girl, we have given the telemark, one telemark here. Then comes the boy. Where is our boy? Here, one. Again, women, again one. Again, women. See, when we have completed four, the fifth one will be given like this. Okay, so that one complete bunch will give you five. It becomes easy to calculate also. Okay, the next one is man, so give one here. Girl, give it here. Again, girl, give it here. Man, here. Man, here. Woman, so give it here. Women, women, women. Okay, then girl, where is girl? Here. Then boy, boy. Then man again. Fourth, women again. Fifth one, no? So cut it like that. So this bunch gives you five. Then boy, where is boy? Here. Then girl, see, four already is there. Cut it like that, girl. Again one girl, man. Four already done, man, gone. Then comes women again. Women, man, man, women, women. Again one woman, cancel. Man, women, boy, woman, girl, man. Here is the fourth one. Again women, one more, women, one more, again one woman, cut, women, one more, girl. Here it is, women, man, fifth one, okay, then man, women, women, man, women, again cancel, girl, here it is, women, one more, man, girl, a fifth one, women, man, fourth one, man, fifth one, boy, where is boy, the fifth one, okay, then girl, again one girl, then comes the women, okay, like this we have got the tally marks, okay. So here see, we have got how many bunches, 1 2 3 4 5, 5 5s are 25 26 27 28, so total frequency comes to be 28, okay. Frequency is nothing but the total number of times a particular event is occurring, okay. Means what? Number of women who are visiting the departmental store in the first hour in the morning is 28. Similarly for men, 5 10 15, okay. So this is 15. Girl, 5 10 12, got it, and boys 5. Now 8 9 10 20 2 3 4 5 6, it means that total 60 people have visited the departmental store in the first hour in the morning, okay. So you can just count the number here, how many people visited, you will find that the total people will be 60 only, okay. So here we have converted this raw data into an organized form according to its frequency. This is what is called a frequency distribution table. So they have asked you to make the frequency distribution table only. So just above this you will just write frequency distribution table. So this is our frequency distribution table, and this is we have made the frequency distribution table using the tally marks. So clear? So here it is done. Now the second part is draw a bar graph to illustrate it. All of you know that what is a bar graph, isn't it? In bar graph what we do, we do the graphical representation of a data, okay, using the bars which are at a particular, which are at fixed distance between each other, okay, and the length, height, or we can say that height of the bars gives you the frequency of the particular data, okay. So here I'm just rubbing this part and I will show you without graph paper only, I am showing you. So but you need to do this one on graph paper only, okay. Here I am showing you how to draw the bar graph, okay. So here what are the different categories of people, women, man, girl and boy, isn't it? So here we will write in the horizontal axis, we will write category of shoppers, okay. So first one will be women, so you have to maintain equal gap, okay. If you are taking this as 5 small squares in your graph paper, okay, suppose this width is 5, then you have to maintain again 5, this and this has to be equal, okay, and this, the width of the graph also has to be equal. So what I am doing is I am taking all 5 5 units, okay. So I am taking this from this, here it is 5, again from here 5, so I am considering this as W, again 5, here W, then M, again take 5, then comes G, again 5, then it comes B. Okay, so these are the different bars. Okay, I have taken the width to be 5 and the gap between them also 5 units. Okay, 5 units means in terms of your graph paper, 5 length of 5 small squares means suppose this is your graph, isn't it? Like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you are taking this one as the distance between 2 bars, then the distance between other 2 bars will also be the same. Okay. Now, along the y axis, you need to put the frequency. Okay. So here it will be frequency. Okay. Just write here frequency. Okay. Now here frequency, we have to consider all these numbers. The smallest one is 5 and the highest one is 28. So it depends on you how you select your scale. Okay, suppose your bar graph is a bigger one, so it's better to start the graph from the lower part so that you are having enough space on the upper portion. Okay, so if I take two small squares, okay, here 2 small squares is equal to highest is 28. No, suppose I am taking 2 small squares is equal to 4. Okay, means 1 small square is equal to 2, like that. It's up to you how you decide. Or you can take 5 small squares is equal to 5 units, or you can take 10 small squares is equal to 5 units. Then it's up to you. I am taking suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, so for 2 small squares I am taking 4, means it is 2, it is 4, it is 6, 8, something like that. Okay, so 4, 2, 4, 8, 6, 8, 10, then 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, like that. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28. I am taking like that. It depends on you how you take. Okay. Now, here see, women, how much? 28. So, here is our 10. This is 10. This is 20. This will be 30. Okay. So, where will be our 28? Definitely here. So, here, it becomes very easy if you do these things on graph paper. Okay, since here it's not possible, I am just drawing like this only. Okay, it may not be exactly done. Okay, so just like that you will be making. So this becomes our 28. Now for men, 15. So if this is my 10, 12, 14, after that 16. So in between 14 and 16, 15 will be lying somewhere here. Okay, so you have to take that one and then you have to draw the bar like this. Okay, this is how you will be drawing. Now for girls it is 12. So if it is 10, 12 is here, so 12 will be. So using the graph it becomes very easy. Okay, here I am drawing taking into consideration, means it's not clear. Okay, means it exactly it's not coming, but when you do these things on graph paper, you are having lines, it becomes easier. Okay, you will be getting the things readily. Now in case of boys, what is that number? 5. So here 2 4 6. So in between 4 and 6, thus just the midpoint between 4 and 6. Okay, so it will be somewhere here. So you have to consider this one and then you will be drawing like this. Okay, if you wish you can write the frequency on the upper part. This is 15, this is 12, this is 5. If you wish, okay, it's not compulsory. So here we are depicting the bar graph. Okay, so you can just give the heading as bar graph. Bar graph showing
the shoppers, shoppers,
shoppers
who came
came
to the departmental store, na? Departmental store,
departmental store
during the first hour in the morning, first hour in the morning.
So this is our bar graph. Whenever you are drawing bar graph, you just write what is this bar graph showing. This one more thing you need to write is the scale. See, for the x-axis, the horizontal axis is called the x-axis, isn't it? For the horizontal one, you need not write, in case of bar graph, you need not write anything. But for the vertical axis, you have to write what scale you have taken.
You will just write the scale here, scale, scale.
So here what we have taken, according to our scale, means our bar graph, we can write two small squares,
one small square
is equal to how much? One small square equal to 2 units, or you can write 2 shoppers also we can write. So it's better to use units. Here what are the units? Units are nothing but the number of shoppers. Okay, so here once you write frequency in bracket, you can write number of shoppers. Okay, these are the category of shoppers. Here number of shoppers. Okay, so who are shoppers? Means here the women. So you can just write frequency, and this is optional, number of shoppers if you wish you can write, otherwise only frequency will do. And scale, one small square equal to 2 units. Why I am writing 2 units? Because here it depicts the number of shoppers only. So if you use this language, you can use the same thing in other bar graphs also. Units, just write the units. And if you write one small square is equal to 2 shoppers for this one, that one is also correct. So this is how we have to draw the bar graph. Okay.